If you guys watched yesterday's video, you saw a much more casual side to Call of Duty. That is what 90% of players play like. 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8 KDs. The average is 0.7, by the way, in Call of Duty. Now, today's video is kind of the opposite side of that. This is what my lobbies typically look like. Now, it's not completely full with, you know, wager, CDL, tryhards all the time, but there's usually about 5 or 6 total in the game. There might be 2 or 3 on their team, 2 on my team, plus me, something like that. It's usually pretty sweaty, you know? And on top of that, I play on keyboard and mouse. I can't really win against good aim assist players all the time. It's pretty hard. I usually have to shoot them in the side, and a lot of times you can't do that. Good players know where to watch the rush routes. They know timings. They give callouts, and that's what you're going to see in this game. This is what pro players do when they play the game. I walk you guys through it while I do it. Now, granted, I'm playing against not as good of pro players. Like, you know, these people are maybe like some wager players or some CDL kids, but they're not, maybe even just competitive players, like the competitive playlist. They are not as good as the pros would be. Having 4 pros on their team with just me on one team, I would lose every time. I would need equal level skill players on my team to have a chance. But I figured, you know, you saw the newbier side. This is what the more competitive side does, always. If you enjoy the video, drop a like, drop a sub. I would appreciate it. It does help me out, and enjoy. On offense, it's gonna be chicken coop into bottom bomb site. It'll be middle ladder to top well jump up. It'll be bottom well door with a smoke. I mean, there's only so many you can take. So like first round, we're gonna do mid cut route, and we're gonna look for somebody on the heady and see if we can just go under him. I'm not gonna grab bomb because I'll be aggressive here.
Yep.
So we're going to come here, we're going to stun the cut, hit marker, we're going to look for the player out here. Since we got a kill there, we're going to back up, we're not going to push through down low. Teammate died behind us in top red, we're going to jump to top well. That was another player, oh my god! So that's the jump, that's the top, what is that, AC. I thought that was a teammate, my teammate's on third story, not watching that. I wonder what they did to go to top red. So if my teammate last round, if you're keeping track of all of them, I had 2 teammates top 3, 1 chicken coop, 1 in middle with me. Middle guy died to red. The only way red could die there is if he went top plat and shot him from there and then jumped red window, or he went top plat, jumped red window, and shot him from there. 3 story should have been able to watch red the whole time or watch the top. 3 story also should have been able to watch the jump across but didn't. Or coop should have been able to see that. Our teammate at Palms is now... he's in a decent spot. He's inside, though. Renetti! I was wondering what that was. I haven't seen much of that lately. Yeah. I mean, we'll do the same thing, except we're gonna do the jump across. We're not gonna go for the kill down and B cut, because that kill, oops, slowed us down. So we're gonna actually just, throw a grenade here. Not even gonna stun it. That'll keep him from pushing. We get the jump up here. We're gonna look for the guy going here. Got him. Get in the room, try to be above that door so we can't see anything. We're listening for bottom well, that door down there to be opened. We're watching the top. They shot me from red, which was the guy that went there last round. I think he got picked up when he went for me though. No, he's getting shot at right now, somebody. So we're gonna have to watch the heady over here. I'm gonna grab this guy's MCW. Use the MCW to cover the long range. Lay down so he can't be seen from any other line behind us really quick. We're gonna just watch the top. There it is. Watching down on the cafe, because that's the heady they go to really often. Bombs down on red side, which means there's probably more than one person there. There's 2 up still. They would have been cleared if they went there. One got flanked, and he just got picked up in the middle from 3 story, I think. Last guy is gonna be somewhere above the bomb or around it. Don't know if he saw it at all. We can kind of like drop and see if he's spot him in there. Nothing to stun it. Pull out a close range gun. Nothing. Check bottom. Nothing as well. Jump back up. We're going to play high. Door is open. Check inside here. We're listening. He was next to the bomb. On to the next. Pushed in with this guy. Even if this guy would have died, I would have got the trade. On defense, again, multiple routes we can take. knowing the map. Pac actually helped me with this route a little bit. Because this was the route I had to use to counter Shifty when I could. So there's no grenade delay in pubs. We can go right and throw a grenade over the wall right away. They might try to stun the cut. If they do, oh well, no big deal. Grenade didn't hit. You can jump on this two prong right here and jump right up with one jump. Jump the wall really fast. We hear him on three story. Damn, that was a 2v1, unfortunately. Ran out of ammo. And the stun didn't hit. Ooh. This is more of a rifle route, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Ladder to top plat, mid plat, and then we're gonna go into red. Grenading it. Stunning red. He's already in there laying down with his rival 9. Should've thrown a real frag there, would've killed him. These guys are sweating for sure, though. They got MCWs and rivals on with trophy systems. We're gonna change it up. We're gonna go middle, bottom well. Stun that. We're gonna have to cut that off. He's gonna go red. Cook a grenade here. We'll try to get down below here. Is he head glitching that? We're good. Grab his MCW. Top's gonna be looking for me in a second. We're getting back here. So we grabbed his gun because we want something that has more range to it. Can watch under that a little bit. There should be a guy on the top plat. Has to be. I can watch bottom well. This is the guy we were scared of, by the way, but he was looking top for the jump across because he's a nerd too. People that play comp on this map a lot do that. Like they'll just sit on this heading and they'll watch the jump across just to see if they get in top well. So they sit right here and just look to see if you clip that. Or they'll sit on that one. He could rotate all the way from back. I kind of should just chill here. Wait, he's on R3, sorry. Wait, I'm picking up through the wall. What the fuck was that? How did I ping him through the wall? Get ready for the next one. PC check, PC check.
Hey, Marchman.
We are nerding out right now. Alright, so they go top plat. I'm actually gonna try to stop that. But to do that, you're gonna need a rifle and beam somebody, or you snipe. You can go to R3 story, or you can just sit right here on this heading and watch him. He jumped instantly into red. That was a shit grenade. He might try to peek this to angle, though. I'm watching middle. That guy's gonna die. I gotta watch her flank too now. No one's watching her flank, which is a problem. So if he gets into red, he's either gonna watch middle from red, or he's gonna go on the flank. I think I have a teammate watching. No, he's actually in the stairwell, not doing shit. There's the flank we were concerned with. Now we have an SMG. Teammate went middle, which means he's not watching flank either. You fucking worthless human being, okay? Now you know why I get mad at teammates. He gave up the fucking flank. For nothing!
Round secure, on to the next.
And that's the difference, when you know where to look versus where you don't know where to look. You blind bitch, you should've helped me.
Marchman, I'm watching the stream. I love you.
Thank you, man. Set a defensive. I hope you're having a wonderful day. I'm not gonna challenge it.
Marksman?
We're gonna go right here and just look across.
It is. I'm watching the stream.
He's on fast. That's crazy.
We're looking there three story. We just heard somebody open a door.
Who's Marksman?
Literally
just. He's a Twitch streamer, YouTuber.
That's crazy.
Fuck.
That is a problem. Don't have a gun. He's gonna do the jump across, probably. Got him, though. That's a bomb. He just dropped his gun down low. One's gonna go well. We're gonna knife him. Actually, no, he's not. This will probably throw him off. I can either sit in chicken coop or I can wait on A. I'd rather sit chicken coop.
1 minute remaining.
What in the motherfucking hell, John?
Enemy bomb at Alpha.
That's okay. The thing is, I'd rather them plant A. It's more predictable and where you can look, like, find people. Nah. MCW.
Nice try.
That's why you don't use a DG. But I didn't have a weapon because I fucked up. Took him off earlier. There we go. Now I got him on.
Defend the objectives from hostile forces.
We're still playing pretty slow right now with a sniper. We could play aggressive if we wanted to. There's just no reason. You just don't have to. We're going to sit right here and watch the jump up. If they try to jump across, we'll see it right there. Otherwise, we watch three-story.
Looks like they're on A in kitchen.
Yeah, they're going to push A. It's okay. Teammates got the kills. Good job, John. Your mic might suck, but your gunny is natural and fucking nasty. Behind me. Maybe. No. Heard my teammate. Okay. Pick a grenade. Gonna go middle, probably.
You've won that round. Get ready for the next one.
Once you kill somebody, there's two methods you can take when you're doing it. You can either sit still and try to hope for it, you know where the second one's coming from, or the next one. Or you get a kill and you instantly move. Usually people do the latter. They don't sit still. Sir, if it's a 1v2, you can do it. If it's a 1v3, 1v4, it's really hard. Like, really hard. You won't see people sit still very often after one kill. It just doesn't work. Looking to see who does the jump across. He loves red. I'm just missing horribly. It's alright. I'm gonna just stare ahead of him. I don't like this that much because I don't want to watch from middle, but it is what it is. I'm just going to unscope out. I got to go three. Our person's on the side there. There we go. Okay, stun myself.
GG's.
The mission is complete. Good work.
GG's, dude. Have a good day.
GG's, marksman.
Love you, marksman.
Good shit. Take care, bro.
Messed up my stun horribly there. Those guys were definitely trying, though. They had on the competitive weapons. They were controllered up. They fucked me up a couple times. But, because they do the competitive routes, it's predictable. There's only a few spots those people sit in. They love those spots religiously. Like, they will go there every time.